And Conneaut coach Christine Crancota fresh off a sweep over Fort LaBeouf in the District 10 3A semifinals. Coach, congratulations, first of all.
Thank you. Girls worked very hard tonight. We're really happy with how they came out and executed.
You guys came in, you had a pretty large fan contingent with you, and it seemed like your bench had a ton of energy tonight. How much does that help the girls to have that kind of energy on the bench and fan support?
It's a big deal. It's a really big factor into their play on the court. Momentum in volleyball, it's a very big deal, and they have a tremendous following. Their student section, their families, their friends, you know, it's to see them consistently come out and support them. It's very humbling, but it's very exciting for the girls. This is what you play for in a high school atmosphere. When the pressure's on, when the stakes are high, and to have a crowd like this show up, and then the girls go out on the court and show out, it's a really cool experience, and it's really fun to be a part of, and it's great that the girls are able to take this in. They're gonna take these memories with them forever.
And it seemed like almost from the first serve tonight, the girls were just really clicking, especially offensively. Is that something you expected from them, or did they perform even better than you were expecting?
Well, they had a solid almost 2 weeks of practice. I think that our concern coming in was the fact that we had such a long layoff, and when you don't get exposed to live, meaningful action, sometimes you have the tendency to develop a little bit of rust. So for them to come out, they didn't necessarily start rusty, but you could tell that their nerves were there. And once they worked through their nerves, we felt that, like you said, they really started to click and they really started to play well together. So we're very proud of them. We have to commend them in that manner, because it's hard to sit for the length of time that they sat and not be a little off your game to start. We knew that Fort LaBeouf had played last week, and we have to congratulate them on a tremendous season. They're a very talented, very well-coached team. But for them to come out and play the way they did tonight, we're very proud of them, but they're a group that is not satisfied. We understand that tomorrow we have to get to work. We're gonna enjoy this tonight, but we still have a lot of work to do if we wanna cross another goal off of our list.
Again, that first set seemed like momentum entirely in your favor, and then the final two sets were just back and forth battles the whole way. Is that what you expected to see from this Fort LaBeouf team? Is that kind of battle throughout?
Oh, absolutely. And we told the girls, any of the four teams left, you know, the D10 title's up for grabs. And we knew coming in that Fort LaBeouf has had a great season, and we anticipated that it was going to be back and forth, like you said. And whoever wanted it more, we said in our pregame chat, was going to be the one to take it. So we encouraged them to come out with energy, to not let the ball hit the floor, work together, play hard, and they did all of those little things. But Fort LaBeouf's a fantastic team. You know, hats off to them.
So you're getting in late into the third set. LaBeouf kind of claws its way back, takes a 23-22 lead. You guys call a timeout. What did you say to the team at that point?
They worked too hard to get to that point and give the third set away. We had talked to them in a timeout earlier in the set. We weren't happy with their complacency on the court. We felt like they were almost waiting for Fort LaBeouf to make a mistake instead of earning our points. And we didn't want that string of points in that third set to come back and bite us. So we challenged them to dig in and play the way that they had been playing, especially at the beginning of the game. And they did. They took that challenge to heart, and they came out and they took the next 3 points. We also challenged them to not play timidly. When you get to that point, you don't want to be the one who makes a mistake, but we wanted the girls to expect the ball to come to them, know what they were doing when the ball came to them, and put it away, and they did. And Mackenzie Wenzel ended on a fantastic swing from the right side.
So looking ahead now to Saturday, you're going to get Villa Maria in the District 10 championship. What kind of match do you expect to see from them?
It's going to be gritty. It's going to be hard fought. There's not going to be anything easy about Saturday. Like I said earlier, we understand that we still have work to do. So we're going to get back in the gym tomorrow. We're going to grind it out, and we're going to do everything we can to prepare them for Saturday. And, you know, the girls are going to come out and execute.
All right, Christine, thank you so much.
Appreciate it. Not a problem.